Hello students, in our last class we are solving the problems on parallelograms, no? We shall solve some more problems regarding the properties of parallelograms and important problems and conclude this chapter today. For that, let me consider one problem. Two adjacent angles of a parallelogram equal in measure. Find the measure of each of the angles of the parallelogram. Here the adjacent angles of parallelogram are given. Let me consider that as ABCD is a parallelogram, A and B are the adjacent angles. Therefore, A is equal to B. That is equal angle. It is measure of equal angles are given here. No? Let me consider A is equal to B, adjacent angles. As we know that A plus B is equal to 180 degree. Adjacent angles of parallelogram are supplementary. No? As angle A is equal to angle B, A plus A is equal to 180 degree. 2A is equal to 180 means angle A is equal to 90 degree. If angle A is equal to 90 degree, angle B is equal to 90 degree because adjacent angles are equal. If B is 90 degree, D is also 90 degree. If A is 90 degree, C is also 90 degree. That means all angles are 90 degree now. Thus, angle A is equal to C is equal to 90 degree and B is equal to D is equal to 90 degree. All the opposite angles and adjacent angles are equal here. All the four angles are equal. Okay. Let us go for one more problem. In this figure, RUNS is a parallelogram. We have to find the value of X and Y here. For that, I am going to use the property, the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other, no? That property we can use. So that means here I can use the diagonal bisect each other property of parallelogram. In this RUNS parallelogram, RN and US are diagonals, O they are intersecting at O, that is bisecting at O. There is, since the diagonal parallelogram bisect each other, US is equal to OS. US is equal to OS here. Therefore, Y plus 7 is equal to 20. Therefore, Y is equal to 20 minus 7 is 13. Y value is 13. Similarly, we shall go for this R, OR is equal to ON. ON is equal to ORX plus Y is equal to 16. Y we found, that is 13 degree. Therefore, X plus 13 is equal to 16. Means 16 minus 13 gives 3. That is X plus, that is X value is 3 now. Therefore, we found that X is 3 and Y is 13. Again, in the adjoining figure, RISK and CLUE are two parallelograms. We have to find the value of X. For that, let us use the opposite angles of the parallelogram are supplementary. The property opposite angles of parallelogram we have to use here. So here RISK and CLUE are two parallelograms. Therefore, OES is equal to angle L, opposite angles, no? 70 degree it is given, L is given. Therefore, E is also, OES is also 70 degree, opposite angles of parallelograms. So, as we know that angle K plus angle OSE is equal to 180 degree. We know that sum of the adjacent angles is equal to 180 degree, no? For that. Angle K it is given already, that is 120 plus OSC is equal to 180 degree. In parallelogram ISKR, that is OSC is equal to 180 minus 120 is 60 degree. Now we found the triangles, that is angles of triangle OSE, that is OSE and OES we found. So remaining angle we can find easy. So in triangle OES, angle X plus OES plus OSE is equal to 180 degree. Angle sum property. So that is angle sum property. Based on that, we can See, that is equal to 180 degree. Angle x plus 70 plus 60 is equal to 180 degree. 70 plus 60 is 130 degree. That is 180 minus 130 is 50 degree. X is equal to 50 degree we can get. So therefore the value of x is 50 degree here in this problem. Hence x is equal to 50 degree. You see here in this figure, we have to explain how this figure is trapezium, which of its two sides are parallel. We have to judge here. Okay, angle 80, angle 100 are given. Either L is equal to 80 and M is equal to 100 degree are given. For that, as we know that angle M plus L is equal to 100 plus 80 is equal to 180. Sum of those two will be 180 degree now. Therefore, angle M and L are adjacent angles and sum of the adjacent interior angles is 180 degree. KL is parallel to NM. KL is parallel to NM. Hence, KLMN is a trapezium, we can judge adjacent angle property here. Based on this, we can say that adjacent angle is, hence KLMN is trapezium. Now similarly, here ABC is a right angle triangle and O is the midpoint of the side opposite to the right angle. We have to explain why O is equidistant from A, B and C. We have to judge. For that, what you can give? The reason. The right angle triangle ABC makes rectangle ABCD by the dotted lines. You can see here. Okay. Since the right angle triangle ABC makes a right angle, that is rectangle ABCD by the dotted line, we can construct, no, if I expand and join. Therefore, that will make OA is equal to OB is equal to OC is equal to OD. The diagonals of a rectangle are equal and bisect each other. We know the property of a rectangle. Okay. So, on that way, we can conclude O is equidistant from ABC. That means O bisects AC and O bisects BD also in equally, that is equally. Again. Okay. That is equidistant from A, B and C, we can conclude. Here it is very easy problem. We have to find the measure of angle P and S if SP is parallel to RQ. Here it is a right angle trapezium. It is called as right angle trapezium. So, okay, Q is given 130, R is 90 degree and S is also 90 degree. We know that the angle sum property, no, PQRS is equal to 360, interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree, angle sum property of quadrilateral, based on which we can find the angle P angle. So take the sum and simplify, you will get P is equal to 50 degree. It is very easy problem, you can do. Now we have to state whether the following statements are true or false. So these are very important items, notable points that you have to judge by reviving the properties of quadrilaterals here, different types of quadrilaterals. All rectangles are squares. Is it true? No, it is false. All rectangles are not squares because the square has all four angles. Of course, all four angles are equal. In rectangle, opposite sides are equal. Here, in square, all four sides are equal. All rhombus are parallelograms. Is it true? Yes, it is true. All the rhombus are parallelogram because all four sides are equal and adjacent sides are equal and opposite sides are parallel here. All squares are rhombus and also rectangles. Is it true? Yes, it is true because all squares and rhombus obeys the properties of rectangle here. Squares and rhombus are equal, sides are equal, and opposite sides are equal and angles, all four angles is equal to 90 degree, right? Now that is right angles. Therefore, all squares and rhombus are rectangles. All squares are not parallelograms. It is false, no? Exactly. Because rectangle and parallelogram. Rectangle, that is square, are all squares are parallelograms. All four angles and opposite angles. Square will obeys all the properties of parallelogram. Hence, all squares are not parallelograms. Because diagonals are not equal in case of parallelogram. But here, square, diagonals equal here. All kinds are rhombuses. Is it true? No, because in kite only a pair of opposite angle are equal, other pair are not equal, and diagonals, of course, intersect each other at right angle. But in rhombus, diagonal bisect each other. Okay, therefore, all kites are not rhombuses. All rhombuses are kites, of course, because rhombuses will obeys all the properties of kites here. So all parallelograms are trapeziums. Is it true? Yes, it is true, because a parallelogram will obey all the properties of trapezium here. A pair, if a pair of opposite angle, opposite sides are equal, then that quadrilaterally parallel. If a pair of opposite sides are parallel, then that quadrilateral becomes trapezium. But in the case of parallelogram, of course, opposite pairs of parallel, that is sides, are equal here. Therefore, all parallelograms are trapeziums. So all squares are trapezium. It is obviously true, because squares are also obeys the properties of all the trapeziums here. Therefore, these are the true or false statements that you have to know, and you should know the reason behind these statements. Okay, so remember all these properties and problems, work the problems properly. This is enough. That's all this chapter is. So in the next class, in the new chapter, we can meet again. Thank you, students.